dancing alongside me, as always, Task Ellis.
Look at all the people who show up when you get a star here.
That's right. To my right, Starter's Blog Editor, Trey Kirby.
Hey-o!
Over there, International Man of Mystery, Leos.
Friends.
And if you can hear me, as I'm screaming at you at home, the fifth starter tonight, number three pick of the 2015 NBA Draft, 76er center, Jaleel Okafor. Jaleel, thanks for joining us, man.
Thank you for having me.
Really appreciate it. How's the summer league experience gone so far?
It's been a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I played my first game here in Vegas last night. We played the Lakers. It was a pretty exciting game. We played in Utah as well. So I'm just getting acclimated, trying to get adjusted to the NBA speed and all that stuff. But it's been fun.
Is it notably different, like when you get out there in that game one? Playing in college, like you said, the speed and physicality.
The biggest difference is the shot clock, and that makes everything that makes everything faster in itself. So that's the one thing I'm really used to.
Keep looking up at it, you're like, whoa.
A couple times.
Exactly. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, but he looked really comfortable out there, despite the sort of the negative news, Joel Embiid being out. But I like your attitude. You said, it doesn't change my role. My role is to dominate. And that's your role out there. And you look comfortable dominating in your first game.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, luckily I was able to play in Utah, get some of the rust out. That was my first time playing 5-on-5 since we beat Wisconsin in the national championship game. So I was able to get some rust off, and I felt pretty comfortable out there last night.
Does that feel like a long time ago when you beat Wisconsin? Because it feels like it's...
Yeah, it does. it really does, unfortunately.
Do you set personal goals heading into this, obviously, upcoming season? I want to make the rookie team. I want to hit these numbers.
Yeah, I want to be rookie of the year. That's one of the goals that my family and I set for myself. Go out there every night, compete, get better, improve. So same thing for summer league, just trying to get adjusted to NBA.
Yeah. Who are you most excited to play against in the league?
Tim Duncan. He's just a guy that for as long as I've been alive, he's been in the NBA.
same with me.
Yeah, even this old fart over here.
So he's my favorite player. Plays my position. He's somebody he's kind of my role model on the floor, and even how he handles himself off the floor as well.
Well, when we knew you were coming on, we did some research. We pretend to be professional here, and took to the internet to find out some facts about you. But the thing with the internet is you cannot trust everything you read.
Right.
Everyone knows that. So with that in mind, it's time once again, we did this last year, for fact-checking, this time with Jaleel Okafor.
Yeah, Chris Bosch, our intern, sent in a little bit.
Chris Bosch actually works for us. He helps us out with these facts. So we found these, again, facts, and I throw facts in quotations because we don't know if they're true or not.
Okay.
We read them on the internet. We're going to give you the question. You'll answer it, and we'll see if they jive.
Okay.
All right? Simple as that. First one, your NBA distant cousin... is
a macro Okafor.
All right. We're one for one.
That one seemed pretty trustworthy.
That one seemed trustworthy. Yeah. Yeah. It was a whole last name. Yeah, there it is. Right there.
Get back soon, Macca.
He was rookie of the year.
This is true.
And we have to know, Lee Ellis, how about those biceps?
They look fantastic.
This guy's a big fan of biceps.
That was a nice arm.
Big fan of biceps.
Oh, yeah. Look at those.
Beautiful. Next question.
Let's get to your buds in the league. Your best friend in the NBA is?
Tyus Jones.
We had Jabari Parker.
The internet said Jabari Parker, but you're...
Well, being last year, Tyus was in the NBA.
Fair enough.
True.
Those are my two brothers.
Fair enough. All right, I love this one. The internet says, or you're going to answer, mythical creatures you believe in are...
Documentaries that I watch are Little Mermaid documentaries, Sasquatch. That's true. I watch
so mermaids,
those.
Bigfoot. All right, I that one checks
those.
Out.
That and you right. think you think Sasquatch is real? Because I do too, actually.
I did, but I'm starting to be a little discouraged because we have all this technology and still don't have any proof.
You're exactly right. Maybe next summer we'll go hit the trails, try and find one.
Let's do it.
I think we'll be successful.
I think we can find some mermaids too. All the talk about the size of your hands. You can fit this number of tennis balls in your hand.
We did 13. That was the most I got.
Okay.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, 13.
Yeah, we've got
there's
a photo
the photo
here
yeah.
in the Bleacher Report studio. 13. Easy.
Do you play tennis at all?
I played in like third grade.
Yeah. Haven't picked up a racket since?
No.
You don't even need a racket. You can just use your hand.
Can I actually get a comparison here, maybe?
Yeah, I got you.
This is crazy to me.
Wow.
Trey Kirby's not a small
Trey
man.
Trey Kirby is a giant man.
Yeah, I'm usually considered bigger on here.
Yeah. Okay, next one here. The internet says your favorite pizza is from?
Giordano's.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. All right. The internet's killing it.
The celeb you've got a little bit of a thing for. Your celebrity crush is?
Jennifer Lopez.
Oh, we had Beyonce. We had Beyonce.
That's
well, I mean,
you can't go wrong.
You can have both.
My biggest one is J-Lo, though.
Of
Okay. Feel very confident about this one because we already talked about it. You modeled your game after
Tim Duncan.
Yeah, okay.
Which came alive as well.
But interestingly, we saw you respond to someone on Twitter. And well, we're going to see a little TD here. This is you going to work. So the footwork.
That's a crazy one.
Exactly. The kiss off the glass. We saw on Twitter when someone asked you, as we get some feedback, who would you say you can compare your game to? You answered a mixture of Allen Iverson and Steph Curry.
Yeah.
Got to expect to see a lot of handles during this rookie of the year, between the legs, behind the back stuff.
You know, I just thought I had a little bit of AI Steph Curry in my game.
Sure. We've seen you knock down a few three-pointers, too, when you did some of those tryouts. So is that something you're going to add to your game this year, do you think?
I know my bread and butter is in the post, so that's where I belong, and that's where I'm most comfortable, but I can do
you
some
never
other
know.
Things. Right.
Let's get to your musical abilities.
I played the tuba.
and what else?
The trumpet in third grade, but the tuba was what I played my freshman year in high school.
Okay.
Third grade seems like a great year, though. Tennis, you were playing the saxophone back in the day. Like, you were killing it in third grade.
I was.
All right. Your favorite TV show is?
Pretty Little Liars.
Nice one.
We didn't have that.
Revenge.
Says the starters.
You know what that show is?
I do.
That's
my second favorite TV show.
Yes. Great job. You're good with the media, too.
You don't need to lie to us, okay? You don't need to lie to us.
And the last one here. Your favorite movie is?
Lion King.
All right. We had Air Bud as well.
Yeah.
That's fair. Lion King was great.
Air Bud is a classic. So not bad. I think the internet's doing a pretty good job.
Which I think you had too much.
You had all the accurate information. There's some false information out there.
Okay. Well, as we do with every guest, we want to thank you for coming on.
Oh, thank you for having me.
But we got you a cake.
Oh.
And
oh
yeah. We didn't
you
know.
You can
what,
take this to your teammates.
We didn't know what to put on the cake, so we just tried to put a giant hand on the cake.
Oh. Yeah, this hand.
Sorry. There you go.
Yeah, we're dropping Oreos all over the place.
Yeah, but it
is a hand cake.
But this is perfect.
Of your gigantic hand.
You said you were hungry, so I mean, feel free to take it.
Guys, I'm a shitter. That was the cake.
Give it up for Jimmy.
Yeah, I got you.
He's sharing cake with you.
Some of the key performances from day three at Summer League. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the starters. Let's palm that cake. Welcome back to the starters live from Summer League night three. Thanks again to Jaleel Okafor for joining us earlier in the show. There was signing some autographs. Oh my God, that guy's freaking out. Oh my God. Relax, man. Relax. It's only night three.
Yourself.
This is a marathon, yeah, not a sprint. All right, so let's get to some of the action from day three. But before we do that, as we've done over the last couple nights, we like to police ourselves when it comes to the Summer League cliche.
Can't say cliche words.
Tass the first night said potential, then Bones last night said fit. So tonight's particular cliche that we need to avoid is out in the fans, out in the crowd. It's future.
Oh, that's going to be tough. Don't talk about the rapper.
Yeah, that's not good. Right. Yeah, good point. So there it is. That's the word we can't say. If you say it, you get blasted. How weak am I? I can't
Come
even
on,
take
man.
Out the
syllogism.
Oh, my God.
What's going to happen at day 12?
There we go. So you get blasted with the syllogism.
It works.
All right, so let's get
you
to some of the action.
You can press the button. That's good.
Some of the key performances from some of these rooks here at day three. Emmanuel Mudiay, the 7th overall pick in the year's draft. He followed an 11-point NBA debut on Friday with game highs of 19 points and 10 assists today in the 98-76 win over the Kings, playing with the Nuggets there. Let's talk about a little bit about this guy. 19-year-old kid, of course, played in China a couple games. He looked great the last two games.
I like how we're starting with the assists right here because he can obviously see the floor. He's a leader, he feels like, out there. Like, he's not looking for his own shot. He's strictly trying to get the guys' shots around him. And I think there's a bit of a willingness to learn. You know, just sitting in the crowd here, watching him on his off day, he's hanging out with Coach Mike Malone,
hanging
out with the assistants when he doesn't have to be. And I feel like he really, you know, this is just from the distance, but it feels like he wants to get better right away.
He played 12 games in China, but it kind of seems like he's just already a mature prospect. He was really controlling the game when he was handling the ball. ball, running point guard, but he played a little bit off the ball too. He just did an amazing job. They ran a ton in pick and rolls, the Nuggets did, and he was just totally in control, changed speeds. He's super strong, just guys flying off of him in the lane. And the thing I love, he would get in the lane, do his little jump up in the air move, and find a guy wide open for three, which is kind of like a next level NBA pass already, and I was loving it.
He's very unselfish. Yeah. That said, he's not afraid to take a shot. He's got 30 shot attempts in the first two games. He's doing a great job of balancing both.
But that's the thing, he's earned that, to be able to take those shots, because the quickest way you're going to get your teammates offside is to just go down there and look for your own shot first, especially when you're a point guard. But he was out there making sure other guys get the touches in first, and then he feels confident and he can step down and knock down that shot. He's a little bit like Damian Lillard was coming into his rookie season for me, that he's just ready. He's just NBA ready. Yeah. And I think the Nuggets are going to be very, very happy with what they've got in him.
Again, the difference between Lillard, of course, the four-year guy coming out of college, this is a 19-year-old kid. I mean, I do think players are going to love playing with him because, yes, he was looking for a shot, again, 30 attempts in the first two games, but he's unselfish when there's a fast break. He's not afraid. Yeah. He doesn't need, like, okay, I'll dribble it up and then create the offense. He'll kick it to the guy ahead. Guys are going to absolutely love playing with this guy. And you wonder if the Nuggets are phoning everyone saying, does anyone want Ty Lawson? I mean, this guy does look like the point guard of...
Not the past, not the present,
but you know where I'm going.
What comes after that?
And as far as you like talking about NBA bodies, this guy has one off the bat. He is just so in control. He looks big. He looks strong. And I think he is going to develop a nice relationship with Coach Mike Malone, just like Mike Malone had a great relationship with DeMarcus Cousins in the end. It looks like they're kicking it off already.
Let's talk a little bit about the Kings, number six draft pick in this year's draft, Willie Cauley-Stein.
Not Vladdy.
15 points. Well, yeah.
Vladdy, DeMarcus.
There's DeMarcus and Vladdy. Willie Cauley-Stein, 7-13 shooting from the floor. He played 22 minutes. Only had one rebound.
Yeah. That was scary. He had to leave the game after that, but he did come back.
That was a hard fall. But again, for the second game with him, you saw the defensive potential mainly and did show little flashes of brilliance on the offensive end.
I think the energy is infectious with him. Mm-hmm. And that, you know, I kind of doubted whether or not he could play with DeMarcus. Defensively, I don't think there's any doubt. Like, he can guard out to the three-point line.
He goes after everything at both ends of the floor. That's what I noticed about him. He doesn't quite have that same touch around the hoop like maybe Jahlil Okafor or Karl-Anthony Towns has, but you just love a guy who hustles like that and works hard, especially a big man like that. He's not just resting on his laurels, he's really trying to work as hard as he can to do everything on both ends.
Yeah, not to mention he is super fast, and like you're saying, he's not a super skilled guy with super great touch, but he is around the ball often. He had 15 points basically just being in the right place, grabbing the ball and being super tall and athletic, able to throw it down, and that's how he's going to score in the NBA. And if he's able to do that now, that's just the future for him.
Cliches! Was that eat it!
It's not gonna come out of his beard.
Yeah, that's not coming out of the beard. That's in that.
In the face!
Wow. Almost.
Well,
you know, people are going to love playing with Willie Cauley-Stein, and I love playing with you, Trey.
Three for three.
This smells very chemically.
It's not healthy. We've gone over that.
You think I'm going to die from this?
Okay, come on, man. Let's go to the past. One of the earlier games.
You got gas in your lungs. I don't think you're going to survive.
Before the Kings and Nuggets was the Bucks and Spurs. Becky Hammon led the Spurs again, coaching to her first win in Vegas with the 89-74 victory over the Bucks. Spurs took control of the contest with a 12-3 run there late in the second quarter. Tass, you've been wanting to talk about Kyle Anderson since we got here to Summer League. You love his game.
I just think he looks comfortable out there. He's a second-year player, and you can tell that he's worked with the Spurs development program because he just looks skilled. There are minutes out there with this really, really stacked team in one spot. They've got nine spots locked in. There's one at the backup small forward spot, and Kyle Anderson, I think, is going to get those minutes. He just looks skilled, can handle, can shoot, he looks long, and he looks like he's just sort of comfortable out there.
He hit both of his three-pointers, got to the line a ton, 10 of 11, great game for him.
He's already been compared to Boris Diaw last season, and you can just see that, because he is very versatile offensively.
Because he's slow.
But he does look slow.
He does, you know, he's a little methodical,
But, you know, he's just got that intelligent basketball IQ, and again, it looks like such a typical Spurs type of player. Again, he'll spend most of this year on the bench just learning and developing, but they're going to want to see him progress, and you can see in 3 or 4 years, Trey might not be able to see him.
Trey is not going to be around.
I literally have a pizza silly string in the back of my throat. It's killing me.
Don't be silly.
I hope you signed a waiver before we did this.
Who knew
show.
It was so dangerous being on TV?
Yeah, that's absolutely right. Kyle Anderson does look good. And the Spurs, again, Becky Hammon.
Yeah, shout out to Becky Hammon. That's great.
Yeah, it's a very cool story here from Summer League. We got to take a break. Lots still to come on the show. Talk a little bit about the Thunder matching the Blazers' offer to keep Enes Kanter.
We'll give these guys some t-shirts back here.
Be short a man.
Can we
get Jahlil Okafor back in case Trey can't make it to the next block? Come on back. You're watching the Starters.
I shouldn't have gone right at your mouth.
Yeah, that was...
Oh, no.
Welcome back to the Starters, live at Samsung NBA Summer League, joined by a few of our friends, which includes Leonardo DiCaprio.
The Ninja Turtle.
That turtle can clap.
Eat a pizza, man. Do some ninja dance.
Yes. Look at him go.
Wow.
He looks very dangerous.
Vegas, man. It's crazy in Vegas.
Impersonators everywhere.
Where were you looking, by the way? Camera.
He's trying to find Raphael.
Yeah, where's Michelangelo? All right, let's get to a little free agency news. The Thunder have match restricted free agent Enes Kanter. $70 million maximum contract offer sheet from Portland, so they will retain him. It is a lot. According to Woj, Kanter's deal includes a player option there on the fourth year and a 15% trade kicker bonus. Reportedly, the Thunder did offer him a four-year, $62 million deal before he signed, as was his right, the offer from the Blazers. The Thunder, of course, could match that bad boy, and they did.
They're going for it. If this was a couple of years ago, they would think about not matching, because that is a heck of a lot for Enes Kanter. It's an overpay. But at this point, with 1 year left with Kevin Durant, they've got to go for it. They had no other way of adding a free agent, so they're overpaying. But I think it would be different a couple of years ago. But they're showing Kevin, hey, we got to do it. And I think that bodes well to keep Kevin around.
Yeah, and it's definitely expensive, but he's going to be able to play well with Serge Ibaka and probably with Steven Adams, too, because they'll be able to back up on his defensive deficiencies. But he's still an incredible offensive player. The Thunder are already a good team, and you're basically just adding a guy who could give you a 20-10 potentially pretty regularly. Maybe he plays off the bench. Maybe he's in the starting lineup. There's a lot of things he can do well, and the things he does pretty poorly are things that the Thunder can cover for. So I'm okay with his signing, personally.
Yeah, Royce Young made a good point about his defense, though, because a lot of people do talk about that, but James Harden wasn't a very good defender from a lot of his career, but he improved. You just work at it, you just keep on trying to get better at it, and I think if Enes Kanter does continue to develop, he has to understand if he's going to be on the floor and score a lot of points, he can't give them up at the other end. So, you know, you don't invest that sort of money in a guy if he's only one-dimensional. You want to try to work with him and try to get the best out of him. So I think that's what the Thunder are going to do, and I think it's a fairly good signing for them.
At this point, though, he is one-dimensional. I mean, it's different because James Harden plays on the perimeter, and Enes Kanter, you put him in a pick and roll, we saw him, guys would blow by him. And with Ibaka, he struggled even the 9 games that they played together. He's got to get better.
Yeah.
And that's the worrisome part, is that if you've got a hole on the defensive end,
but remember,
you're
James
get
Harden,
exploited.
Until this season, was a horrific defender, and he got better at it. You know, you can improve at it.
Yeah, he's only 20. Enes Kanter is 23 years old.
Yeah,
he's
exactly,
extremely young.
Exactly, and he's just a guy who's still getting familiar, just playing probably in the NBA, playing in that position. There's a lot of good players, good offensive players. All he has to take is a little bit of work in the offseason, a little bit of work during the season, just to move your feet, get a little bit of better understanding positioning, and I think he can improve.
And because of where they are with the cap, this was the only way
to do it.
I mean, that's a big, big move. Like, if they could go sign a free agent that helped them a little bit more, then I think they would have done that.
Yeah, I think Harden's name is coming up with this Kanter signing here because the Thunder are going into the luxury tax threshold this season, for one season, and then, of course, it's going to explode the salary cap there, and they're still going to have the potential to sign Durant to a max super contract. But they didn't do that with Harden.
Yeah.
They didn't want to play with that going into the luxury
tax,
and that's why
that's
coming up.
Yeah, they probably learned from that as well, that they probably should have gone in there with James Harden, but they didn't.
That's absolutely right. Well, on last night's show, if you joined us, we challenged our boy Brent Barry here to try and slip in 5 Starters-inspired phrases during today's Suns-Rockets game on NBA TV. So let's find out once and for all how Bones did. Take a look. First one. Any point in the broadcast, you got to say dinkers and dumpers.
Of course, threes are inside, so we're talking about dinkers and dumpers.
Second one, a little more difficult. You have to say in a Southern lawyer accent.
Holy, Trey. What is this, Pelican Brief?
We got ourselves a game.
And right now they've cut it to 2.
Well, as they say in Houston, we got ourselves a game.
You have to mention Mavericks great Mike Isolino.
But you know what? So far, no one reminds me of Mike Isolini. Isolino. Isoruno. Isorunio Nionio.
A classic. You have to meow on the air.
A lot of Kentucky flavor on this, not only Summer League squad, but the regulars as well.
Well, meow.
In your best Australian accent, you have to say...
That's what I call a very solid
play. What is wrong with
tonight?
You tonight? Right.
That was a very solid play. That's what you have to say.
I wonder how much willingness there is as Harrell is ever able to get to the middle, and that was a solid play.
So you do an Australian accent as well.
That one was for a friend of mine, and that's the last thing that I'm going to do, Spiro, that will bother you, at least for this game, until our next game.
I just wanted to say, you're my hero.
Skeets, Tass, Trey, Australian guy. I don't think I've ever gone 5 for 5 in broadcasting. I've done it on the court, but I did it today. So the color commentator challenge is complete, 5 for 5. And I'd like those contributions to be made to the Surf Rider Foundation. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Wow.
Great
job,
Bones. Impressive.
$250 for the cherry of Bones' choice to see it there, surfrider.org.
Cheated a little bit with Mikhail doing
that. Yeah, I got a little help.
No, that was great. That was
great. Spread it around.
That was amazing.
I think we need to do this like every Thursday night during the regular season.
We know a lot of broadcasters.
That's absolutely right. All right, we got to take a break. When we return, Lee's very solid Summer League play of the day. Come on back. Time for Lee's very solid play of the day.
It comes from the Nuggets in the Kings game, and I have to give a shout out to Trey Kirby for this one because he found it, and it is a beauty. All five Nuggets touch the ball, and it ends with a beautiful layup from Joffrey Laverne. Look at this. This is what we want to see. Joffrey Laverne with a beautiful finish, and that's what I call a very solid play.
Yeah, Lee.
That's
right.
A five-pack of Nuggets.
That's a good one. Let's take a look at the Samsung NBA Summer League upcoming schedule. There it is. 8 games on Monday, July 13th. Lakers, Knicks. Excited for that one. 8:30 p.m. Eastern on NBA TV. Remember, you can catch and watch all these games over at NBA.com/SummerLeagueLive. That's it for night 3. We will return following the Jazz and Wolves tomorrow. Trey will hopefully be with us.
Thanks for joining us. And remember, people work out before they get to Las Vegas, not when they're in Las Vegas.
Embrace the night, people.